Hello and welcome to the History of Viruses. Today we are going to discuss the evolution of the Ebola virus, a highly contagious and deadly human pathogen. Ebola is a single-strand RNA virus that relies on its own error-prone RNA polymerase for replication, which does not proofread the nascent nucleotide strand, unlike DNA polymerases do. For this reason, nucleotide substitutions are often introduced into the Ebola's genome. Most substitutions are neutral, they do not affect viral adaptation, and they mostly result in the conservation of a protein's amino acid sequence due to the redundancy of the genetic code. We call them synonymous substitutions. Some substitutions are non-synonymous. They change protein amino acid sequence and are usually deleterious, rendering viral progeny non-functional and extinct through natural selection. Rarely, some substitutions will grant viruses a selective advantage in the new hosts and, accordingly, are the driving force of viral evolution. During the 2014 Ebola outbreak, the virus was rapidly spreading and claiming lives, yet we knew nothing about how the nucleotide substitutions in Ebola's genome made this virus so contagious and deadly. Nucleotide substitutions may alter protein sequences or other biological targets, so monitoring them is essential for understanding viral evolution, vaccine development, and future outbreak control. This idea encouraged Pardis Sabeti's research team to sequence and analyze the 2014 outbreak genomes in an attempt to understand how the virus was evolving and spreading. The team ran next-generation sequencing, NGS, on patient samples to precisely sequence Ebola genomes by constructing a DNA library, sequencing by synthesis, building the genome, and comparing it with known Ebola genomes in search of nucleotide differences. The NGS identified that synonymous substitutions always predominated non-synonymous substitutions. This result is supported by the idea of the molecular clock and the neutral theory of molecular evolution proposed by biologist Motu Kimura. Dr. Kimura found most nucleotide substitutions to be neutral, not affecting viral evolution, and that these substitutions change in frequency randomly through genetic drift or genetic hitchhiking, while appearing at roughly the same rate in all genes. You might ask, what is genetic hitchhiking? Let's imagine neutral substitutions to be rats. If there is a beneficial substitution in the genome, then the rats will survive unless they are eliminated by a stochastic process called genetic drift. They may also be eliminated due to the effect of co-occurring with deleterious substitutions. Nonetheless, because the neutral substitutions are accumulated in a genome at a relatively constant rate, there's a linear relationship between neutral substitution numbers and elapsed time. This relationship is quintessential for the molecular clocking model, where tracking substitution fixation can uncover viral evolution and aid in contact tracing. The molecular clocking found a substitution rate of 8×10⁴ per nucleotide per year. Given that the Ebola's genome is roughly 19,000 nucleotides, 15 substitutions would fix in Ebola's population per year, and 45 substitutions would point to 3 years of viral evolution taking place. In fact, the molecular clocking suggested that the three most recent Ebola outbreaks diverged from a common ancestor around 2004 as independent zoonotic spillovers from the same viral pool. Sabeti's investigation showed a worrisome trend. The nucleotide substitution rate was twice as high within the 2014 outbreak as between the outbreaks. The virus was also fixing more non-synonymous substitutions, pointing out that Ebola virus was likely adapting to its new host, humans. Indeed, the genetic similarity between the 2014 Ebola virus strains suggests a single zoonotic spillover, the sustained human-to-human transmission. Furthermore, the molecular dating, combined with contact tracing, characterized the transmission routes. The 2014 Ebola virus outbreak began in Guinea and spread to Sierra Leone as two clusters, giving rise to a third, very contagious cluster, as was found by a fixation of the particular nucleotide substitution, aiding viral infectivity. Nonetheless, Sabeti's research not only characterizes Ebola evolution and transmission, but also provides anyone around the globe with an invaluable list of nucleotide substitutions to develop better theragnostics and outbreak responses. Furthermore, this research helps shape our understanding of RNA virus evolution. And why is this so important? We live in an epoch where global travel, primitive theragnostics, and other factors give some RNA viruses a perfect soil to see the global plague. So, let's not give them a chance. See you later!